September 24th. It's approximately 7:25, and I am just about to leave to go pick up Max. This is going to be one very long day of driving. Once I get Boudica back inside from her doing her dawn patrol, running around, smelling smells and such, I will be heading out, and in about 12 hours or thereabouts, I should be up in Mooresville, North Carolina, waiting for Max to get loaded into the car so I can start coming back. We'll see what happens. This is the road. This is 95. We are just a little bit south of Daytona and about an hour away from Jacksonville. On our way up there, it's 10:47. So all in all, we're making pretty decent time. We were delayed by an oversized load that slowed us down by 20 miles an hour for probably 10 miles. But the upside is that we are still making good time. It's out of our way, and we, after I stopped and got some coffee and took a short break, we are still making good time. And I'm still expecting to be up in North Carolina on reasonable close to schedule. Still got 175 miles left on the tank before I gotta stop and refuel. We're doing good overall. We are just south of Jacksonville. This big honking beast with all the flashing lights and the sign that says oversized load is what slowed us down south of Daytona. I'm glad we're on a through lane now, so we can get around him. He's very slow. Okay, right now, I am on A1A. How I missed 9A, I have no clue, but this is the last time I'm going to follow Google Earth's directions as far as anything that takes me off of 95 when I gotta get back onto 95 anyway. Either way, this is another delay because the directions I got messed up. So now I have to find my way back to 9A and then to 95. That's apparently, according to the locals, the only way I'm going to cross the St. John's River, which, of course, 95 crosses for certain. So, hopefully it won't set me back too long, but I made good time coming up here, so maybe it'll end up balancing out in the end. Anyways, I hope you've enjoyed this little view of A1A up near Jacksonville. And we'll enter more later. Forget 9A. I found 202 West to take me out to 95, where I will continue on 95. And to heck with any potential traffic problems that may occur, because 95, even with traffic, beats the heck out of being struck on surface streets for miles and miles and miles. And once I can stop and top off my tank, I will be one happy camper. So 202 West to 95 is my new and approved route. Okay, we passed into Georgia a little bit ago, about 5-10 minutes ago. Finally got back on the 95, just in time for Jacksonville to cross the St. John's River. And updated Eleanor at home, let her know what's going on. We're a little bit behind the original schedule, but ahead of what the Google Maps said we should be. So that's both good and bad on a number of different reasons. traffic is fairly moderate, as you can see. Few people moving faster than me, but that's okay. Anyway, so I'm hoping to be up there a little bit earlier than planned to pick up little Max. Okay, we are in South Carolina. We got into across the state line about 20 minutes ago, and it's been off and on rain at various levels of rain the entire time. I am so glad I did not bring the bike. I suspected I might be hitting rain the entire way up, and well, I was partly right. As you can see on the window, you can see the rain hitting us. And those big nasty clouds up there are bringing it down. And I'm still waiting to come up on I-26 so I can start heading west or northwest towards North Carolina, where I need to go into Mooresville. Ah, what fun.